Timely feedback is often the difference between a valuable learning experience or a lesson in patience. And that's definitely true when programming. In this course, you'll be using embedded MATLAB programming exercises, which provide both instant assessment and helpful feedback if your solution's not quite right. This way, you can learn from and fix your mistakes without waiting for someone else to find them. But before attempting your first MATLAB exercise, let's take a look at an example to see how to enter, submit, and troubleshoot a solution. We'll start by looking at the instructions. In this example, we need to solve a system of linear equations. In particular, we must create a matrix A, a vector B, and another vector X, which will contain the solution. Now that we've read the instructions, let's move on to the next section where we enter a solution. In this problem, the instructor has chosen to provide us with a partially completed script to give us a head start. Note that the gray area is not editable. Our task is to complete the code in the editable section according to the instructions. Let's give it a try. Now that we've completed the script, we'll run it using the Run Script button. This way, we can make sure our script runs without error and that any output, including variable values and plots, looks reasonable. Uh-oh. It looks like our script generated an error. According to the message returned by MATLAB, the error occurred at line 15, so we'll look for a mistake at or before that line of code. Oh, it looks like we accidentally created B as a row vector instead of a column vector. After fixing this mistake, our script now runs without error. If you ever find yourself stuck with a tricky error, however, you can use the MATLAB documentation link to get help with MATLAB commands and functions. You can also reset the script to its initial state and start over, or save your current solution if you'd like to take a break and finish it later. Now let's submit our solution for assessment by clicking on the Submit button. Our solution is run again, and this time the results are checked by several assessments provided by the instructor. A checkmark is displayed next to assessments that passed, while an X is displayed next to any that failed. It looks like we made a mistake. Since the value of variables created earlier in the script may affect those created later, let's start by examining the first failed assessment, which checks the value of the first variable we created, the matrix A. In addition to a standard message, the instructor has provided an additional hint to help us troubleshoot our code. After returning to our solution, it appears one of the elements of A does not match the corresponding matrix coefficient in the instructions. Once we correct this mistake and resubmit, our script now passes all of the assessments. Now that we've finished this problem, it's time for you to start yours. Just remember, check marks of green, your code is clean.